Honestly, bro, you just have to get that experience. Like five approaches a day, like you said, just get that experience. That's all the thing. Like, bro, son, you know how many approaches I did in college, bro? How many times I got rejected? If you looked at my approach to like lay ratio, it's probably something crazy. Exactly. And then we actually addressed this point earlier. Do you still think cold approaching is still a good idea in 2020? Yeah, we talked about this earlier, but basically, like, you can still cold approach in 2020. If anything, it's better now because of quarantine, because guys aren't approaching. So now if you approach a girl, she's like, oh, this guy's finally confident. Oh, someone's actually talking to me. So it's better to approach now because, like, most guys aren't doing. And when you're doing stuff that other people aren't doing, that's how you get farther in life. Yeah.
That's a funny ass name, that random person on you. That's funny. But hell yeah, bro. And that's the thing. Think about it, bro. What are you doing on social media? What are you doing on dating apps? You're trying to see her in person anyway. And understand it's going to be a lot more nuance. It's going to be a lot more subtlety. It's going to be a lot more of a different energy meeting a woman in real life. So, for example, let's say you're on a dating app, or let's say you're on Instagram or whatever, and it's an Indian chick on there. She's never dealt with black guys. Her first reaction when she sees a black guy is to swipe left or to not respond. Well, in person, she may be like, I'll give it a try. Because he approached me, most black guys, or most guys in general, don't approach me anyway. So you can change their mindset. Nothing's going to be human to human interaction. You know what I mean? All this other shit can help. But at the end of the day, you're on the day nap to see her in person, I hope. They haven't made a way for you to fuck a chick through your phone yet. Now, who knows? Technology's getting crazy. It might happen one day, but it ain't happening yet. Nothing's going to beat the old school human-to-human interaction. Like, for example, me and you doing this interview now, it would probably be different if we did it in person. You know what I mean? Maybe the same topics, but the energy would be different because it's real life. Keep in mind, bros, we're still real people that want to connect with other people, and that doesn't change just for women. So nothing going to beat cold approaching, no matter what year, no matter with the mask. Telling you, the mask helps you with your eye contact. It lets you understand how beautiful women's eyes are, because that's all you get to see. And it also brings another side of mystery, because now when you see her again without the mask, it kind of feel like you're dealing with another chick. You know what I mean? From the one that you approach. So approach as much as you can, bro. In real life, up to people. Because approaching is way deeper than just women, bro. It can help you get pulled over. If you know how to talk to people, the cop may not write you a ticket. It can help you get a football game for free. It can help you get in a concert for free. It can help you talk your way out of some trouble that you may have been in. But it starts from approaching. It's way deeper than women, bro. You can become a CEO of a company just by knowing how to talk to people on the elevator. You know what I mean? So, yeah, bro.
Nah, that's fast. Like, even like, bro, approaching guys, son. Like, I ended up talking to some guy basically like at the laundromat like a couple years ago, bro. I met him. He was cool as hell, bro. He ended up giving me like a job that I was not even qualified for at all, just because I talked to him. Like, yo, bro, you see, I forgot what game was playing, but I talked to him about the game, and that ended up getting me a job, bro. And you just naturally become better at talking to people too. And also, he said a valid point too. Like, bro, on dating apps, bro, girls like get so many options. They just want notifications. Basically, like, I remember this is one girl, right? I look on dating apps, oh, she's all right. And I seen her in person, and I just end up going to approach her. And then I realized, like, yo, I matched with this girl. But on the dating app, she was curving me, not giving me no attention. As soon as she seen me in person, bro, she was geeked on me. She was all over me. So it's like, bro, it's like, that's how it be. So like, you never know what can happen when you're approaching girls. The mindset shouldn't be like, oh, it's 2020, it's quarantine, COVID. The mindset should be like, yo, I'm a wavy guy. If I go talk to her, she's gonna fuck with me, bro. So that should always be your mindset. Yeah, we touched on approach anxiety so many times, right?
Oh yeah, yeah. Somebody asked about
it. Yeah, we talked about that so many times. Yeah, but basically, yeah, approach.
You said it's not. It doesn't exist. It only exists in your brain. All you're doing is talking to another human being. Quit putting labels on it. Quit putting titles on it. Quit diagnosing yourself. If you didn't, like, literally get diagnosed, and even if you did, it's still not real because you had to talk to the doctor. Like, bro, it's not a real thing. Just go out and talk to people. It's always going to be a little nervous. You're always going to get a little butterflies if she's hot and it's your first approach or whatever. But guess what? I do too, and I've been approaching for over 10 years. Just do it.
So then how do you, like, the shy guy, like, become, like, a social person? Like, because, like, you know, not everybody is one with charisma. But how does this...
I would say he has to start, like, everybody has shyness to them, you know what I mean? Like, there's certain situations where I'm shy, you feel me? But everybody had to start somewhere, and the first step is, of course, to go out, get out your house, go out, please, get out the house. And by doing that, you just start moving your mouth, because everybody has some shyness in them. You can relate to somebody just off that. That could be your approach. Hey, man, I'm kind of shy, but, you know, I'm just trying to work on talking to people. Or, hey, I got a little anxiety, but I told myself I was going to try. And you'll be surprised how many people will be able to relate to you. And even with women, they'll take the pressure off the approach if you tell them up front that you don't do this much or that you're shy or whatever. They'll be in the same category as every other guy who appears to be confident.
So where you're like, so the guy should usually, like, say, like, a friend, like, he's a shy guy, he doesn't really do this as much, and you said she'll respect him at first
as long as he's genuine with it. I wouldn't say that a line, or I wouldn't say that a strategy or a method. If you're genuine, if that's how you're feeling, because even me, I've done so many approaches in my life, but still first approach of the day, it feels like the first one of my life. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Guys think that anxiety is going to go away, bro.
Hell no.
Yeah, meeting a stranger, this shit is, it's intense for a sense. But once you do that first one, especially for the date, it's a lot more easier.
That's straight back. Are you still doing cold approaches? Like, and wait, how's it quarantine in Atlanta, Alabama?
Oh, it's cool, bro. It's cool. You know,
it should open up.
Yeah, for the most part, yeah, like restaurants and all type of shit. You know, everybody has to wear masks, but yeah, we're open up, bro. I've been getting more girls cold approaching now during quarantine.
Oh, because
I say this all the time, bro. Guys weren't approaching anyway. It's rare that guys, when you're out and about, approaching women anyway. Now they have the ultimate excuse. Oh, it's quarantine. Oh, she has a mask on. Oh, she's at work. So that makes it easier for me. And it also helps you with your eye contact. Don't realize how amazing other people's eyes look until quarantine, because you know, look at them in the eyes.
I'm a shy guy, so I really don't be shooting. I freeze up thinking about what I can say to them. Anything, how can I work on that?
Do 2 to 5 approaches a day, bro, and you have no excuse because it's quarantine, so you got plenty of time. Shoot your shot, bro. Talk. And here's the thing, talk to everybody. It's always such a big difference when you're talking to women, because you're not talking to anybody else except for the women you want to talk to. So that's why you freeze up. That's why you get so shy. 2 to 5 approaches a day, starting today. You know what I mean? Start interacting with other human beings, bro. That's what's going to help you out. That's what's going to help you work on this. I can't give you no method. I can't do it for you. Prince O can't do it for you. Nobody can do it for you. Only you are going to know what's best for you when it comes to game. And that's why when it comes to, like, approaching and shit like that, that's why I try not to be too specific on what to say, because guys are quick to say, oh, it didn't work. Oh, okay, so just talk to people, bro. That's going to be your best bet.
Nah, and that's straight facts. Like, I think you said you worked in sales too, right?
Yeah.
So even working in sales, like, you're constantly talking to people. Even if you have a career where you're constantly talking, you naturally have to end up getting better because you're talking to people. Like, you can't just be talking to girls all day and think you're just, well, you can, but you have to talk to people in general. You just have to know people nature in general. So that's how you kind of get good. And, like, freezing up, son, you're thinking too much. You're not being in the moment. Just think about it for a second. Like, it's not that simple. It's not that hard to have conversation. It's simple. You do it every day. Like, you talk to your mom. It's simple to have conversations. But you're putting too much pressure, and you're trying to figure out, like, how do I game her? How do I get her to actually like me? Just be in the moment for a second. Stop thinking about the future. Stop thinking about the results. Yeah.
Yeah, and also, when you do your approaches, you made a good point there, bro. Like, definitely be in the moment. And also, in a sense, approach is kind of like sales. You know, mm-hmm. like you're going up to a stranger and you're convincing them of whatever you want to convince them to. So even if you got to have that salesman mindset, you don't want to have that salesy vibe, because you know when they got that vibe, you like you can tell they want something from you. But at the end of the day, you know, like if that's what's gonna help you, do that. Just get out, bro. Get out the house, hit the field, start talking to people, and all the answers will start to come.
And honestly, bro, you just have to get that experience. Like 5 approaches a day, like you said, just get that experience. That's all the thing. Like, bro, son, you know how many approaches I did in college, bro? How many times I got rejected? If you looked at my approach to like lay ratio, it's probably something crazy.
And that's what everybody who approaches a lot, because I always say this, I'm like, it's rarely any guys who have got rejected more than me. Why? Because not that many are doing as many approaches as me. So basically, when I say that, I could do 5,000 approaches and get rejected 4,000 times. Well, I still got success in 1,000 compared to a guy who only did 5 approaches and got rejected all 5 times. So it's all about moving your mouth, bro. Because that's the only thing you're gonna get good. You gotta know, you gotta start talking to people. That's it.
Exactly. Nah, that's facts though. And stop worrying about your rejections, bro. Son, honestly, son, you probably just laugh at the rejections at this point. Like when I get rejected, it's like, ooh, sometimes I just laugh at it. It's funny at this point.